Now then, what's all this about? We were out the other day looking for farmers markets and locally produced food and that, and we went over to a place called Nelson, Lancashire, and noticed this noise. If we just get out of this for a moment. This is a mosque, and what was going on was, it was a Sunday, and there was this loud wailing coming from speakers being blasted out to a residential neighbourhood. Now, as soon as you start talking about mosques, Muslim religion, any of that stuff, you're castigated as being a racist. Now, let's get it straight. I am not a racist, but I do object to any religious organisation blasting out their propaganda to a neighbourhood. Now, if you want to know how prevalent this has become, this is Blackburn. You can zoom in on Blackburn and you can count them all. These are all mosques, 43 in total, and those are the official ones. 43 mosques. I mean, look at that. How many churches do you think there are in Blackburn? Now, I know that could be directed at the Christian. I mean, God knows, I don't. God knows, irony. I don't subscribe to any religion. But if you cannot see how a town is being taken over by just that picture alone, then I think you can't see the wood for the trees and you're being too politically correct and you don't want to offend people. But this is wrong. The racket that was coming out, I mean, it's a Sunday, it's a quiet Sunday, it was a lovely day, and all you can hear is going all across the neighbourhood. I'm sorry, but this is Great Britain. This is England. That sounds immediately like you're on the BNP front. Ah, this is England. It's not the case. People from other countries are taking over this country. It's as simple as that. Simple as that. If you're happy with that, that's fine. I'm not happy with that. And what culture we've got left in this country, I don't want it turning into a different culture. That might be protectionism, protection, I can't even speak. That might be Little Englander, even though I'm Welsh, coming out. But could you imagine another country? God knows the British have done it in the past, taking over other countries, and that's a shameful scar on our history. But I cannot imagine today going into India and putting 43 churches in a small town and getting away with it. I don't know, I might be wrong, but if that doesn't look strange to you, that amount of mosques, then I don't know. Anyway, I'm sure this will get reaction because it's a reactionary subject, but unless you live in a town that's split in two, such as Blackburn, you won't realise the problem. I have no problem with tolerance, no problem with integration, but that isn't what's taking place. We've got isolation and we've got ghettoisation, if that is even a word. Right, I'm up to 4 minutes and I'm just waffling now. So, I don't know, I'd welcome comments on this, I really would. And not just from the people calling me a racist, because this really is not a race issue, this is a cultural issue. And it's a I want of a quiet Sunday issue actually. If I had my music blasting out, and God knows I'd love to, have my windows open and say, right, let's have a listen to, I don't know, Rage Against the Machine all afternoon. I'd dutifully have the council coming round sticking an order on me to shut up. These guys are condoned for, even sponsored by councils, to blast this crap up. Crap, it's not crap, it's what they believe in. And I'm not going to swear on this because, much as I'd love to, because it does annoy me. But it is their freedom to believe in what they believe in. It's not their right to blast it across an entire neighbourhood. So, regardless of where they are and regardless of what country they're in. If you want to practice that sort of thing, fine, do it behind your own closed doors. Don't knock on my door and certainly don't blast it through my bedroom window. Oh dear, right. I didn't mean it to be that long, but everyone have a nice day and I look forward to your comments.